What's going on, everybody? So if you guys tuned into the Washington Redskins Club Series yesterday, you would have seen Ghost putting on an absolute clinic, cruising passes to opponents and winning the championship. Now, he did so out of the Gun Bunch formation, primarily from that West Coast playbook, and his passing stats just speak for themselves. 30 for 34, 331 yards, 3 touchdowns, 1 pick, 9.74 yards per attempt, and a 133.33 passer rating. Now, that one interception was actually because of an odd pass lead on a corner route. The corner route was open. The pass lead went a little bit too far downfield, and the corner was able to step in front of it and pick it off. So he very easily could have had a perfect passer rating on the day. So very, very impressive. And he really did it running mainly three different plays. It was mesh post, dig halfback out, and corner strike. And what he did very effectively, specifically out of mesh post and dig halfback out, was basically both of those plays have routes on the field that are essentially unguardable by any zone coverage. Now, his opponents were running a lot of 3-3-5 Tampa 2. His first opponent, the Great Gatsby, was, and then his second opponent was actually running a lot of cover 3. So they were having a ton of trouble stopping those routes without having to user them. So in this case, you're going to see Ghost run a mesh post play, actually second play of offense for him against his first round opponent, the Great Gatsby, motion out the mesh post, and this is the vaunted, you know, 3-3-5 Tampa 2 aggressive pass rush, rushing 4, and he drops the middle linebacker into that standard, you know, deep third. So it's essentially a cover 3 with the middle linebacker dropping deep. But what this play does is it opens up the middle of the field and really forces people who want to user the entire middle of the field. As you can see, Gatsby's user defender, the only defender he has over the middle of the field right there, he's going to get put in a one-on-one ISO scenario, and he's going to have to pick one or the other route. And Ghost is so good and has run this play so many times, he's basically never going to make the wrong read. So you're going to see the post route coming over the middle, and then you're going to see the underneath route. And that's going to put that high-low, or that middle linebacker rather, in a high-low situation where he does not have a right decision. And this is just what Ghost basically did the entire tournament. Very easy pitch and catch. A lot of times his opponents would peel off and user that deep post route, and that's when the discipline of Ghost comes into play. You have to be fine with checking it down and hitting that drag route over and over and over and taking what the defense gives you. So right here is actually going to be an example of the dig HB out setup in the championship matchup against Buck Sweep, also the second play of the game. And you're going to see the window dressing to make it look just like mesh post. You're going to notice he motions out Mike Wallace once again to give it that look. But Mike Wallace's time is running the drag, and now the deep post is coming from the left solo receiver. As you can see, three deep shell from his opponent, Buck Sweep. 1, 2, 3. So cover 3 shell, and Buck Sweep's user defender playing very aggressively. So he basically, at this point, has no other option other than to just sit on the drag. As you see him down here, there's no way he's making it back to that post in time. So at this point, he just has to basically take his losses, sit on the drag, and hope Ghost makes a bad read or that his quarterback overthrows. But you see how effective that deep route is against zone coverage. You're going to have a lot of trouble trying to mark that guy if you're playing a straight zone coverage type of scheme without peeling off and using him. Now, if in this case, imagine if Buck Sweep were to, instead of playing very aggressively, say Buck Sweep right here, instead of playing underneath on that drag, instantly ran back to try and guard that post route. Imagine that defender not being there, his user being deep down the field. Now all Ghost has to do is check down the drag. If Buck Sweep's user is down here, Ghost hits the drag on the left flat, turns up field, make a juke, make a spin, and get easy yards. Take what the defense gives you and be very, very disciplined. And that's basically what Ghost did throughout this entire tournament, and it worked very, very well for him. So this third and final example is going to be from late in his matchup against Bug Sweep, and this is just going to show what kind of problems you put on your opponent defensively in terms of trying to make adjustments to try and slow down the mesh post and the dig HB out, and then along with the constraint play of corner strike, which, make no mistake about it, corner strike is a pivotal part of this offense. He called it twice as much as any other play, and it's basically just there to keep your opponent honest. You know, if you get too cute trying to make adjustments to stop the mesh post and stop the dig HB out, then you get nickel and dime down the field by corner strike, high-lowing your outside flat zones, and then once you adjust to that, bam, hits you back over the middle with a high-low situation on your either your user or your mid-zone defender. So right here, just going to be an example of, you know, Buck Sweep getting desperate, trying to make adjustments to slow down this play. Once again, you see the same motion out from Mike Wallace, and this is actually going to be mesh post, but in this case, Buck Sweep goes, looks like he had a cover three type of shell, tried to send some pressure to get Ghost off his mark in the pocket. You see the safety shooting over into the middle, but it looks like he put both of his outside zones into flats. It might have been, it looks like cloud flats, but he's trying to, you know, bring that coverage down to make him say, okay, You know, I'm going to user the over-the-middle post. In this case, it's going to be being run by the B receiver, and these flat zones are going to come down and make a play on that drag route. But when you get too cute, even the clear out route is still a weapon, especially against cover three in the seam and cover two over the middle. Right here, Ghost realizes it. And this is also very high-level play from Ghost. This is the first time I saw in this game that Buck Sweep did this with his outside zone defenders. And the first time he did it, Ghost made him play for it. Perfect bullet pass. Notice the outside pass lead away from the safety. It's the small things like that that can really turn the tide in a game and that make or break a play. If Ghost doesn't go with that outside pass lead, that middle safety probably makes a play on the ball. Outside pass lead, easy catch, although his receiver made it look a little hard diving for it right there. Going up 14-3 and really sealing this game for Ghost. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. I thought Ghost just put on a really, really good display of high-level Madden in that Washington Redskins Club Series, and wanted to do a little breakdown of his offense. I've talked about the West Coast Gun Bunch before, definitely very popular, but it's looking like Ghost is definitely the front runner in terms of, you know, one of the best players, if not the best player in the world, to run that offense, and he's got to be up there in consideration for the best bunch player in the world right now, with the likes of Skimbo. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, thank you so much for watching, and until next time, guys, take it easy.